Hello students, I'm Teacher Liang. As you delve deeper into first-year mechanics, many of you may start to find it challenging. Mechanics is a fundamental part of the entire high school curriculum. It's fair to say that if you don't master mechanics in your first year, you'll have a very hard time later on. So in this video, I'll use an example to walk you through the three core methods of force analysis in high school that you must master to help you solidify your foundation. Let's look at this example problem. Given an object of mass m, at rest on an inclined plane fixed to the ground, the angle between the plane and the horizontal is alpha. Find the support force and the friction force acting on the small block. Now let's go through the three methods one by one. The first method is the force composition method. The object is subject to three concurrent forces: gravity, the support force, and the friction force. When at rest, the net force is zero. The resultant of any two forces is equal in magnitude and opposite in direction to the third force. We can combine the support force and the friction force. Their resultant force is equal in magnitude and opposite in direction to the force of gravity, forming a right-angled triangle. By using trigonometric functions, we can directly calculate the support force and the friction force. The second method is the orthogonal decomposition method. This is the most commonly used method for force analysis. The key is to first establish a suitable coordinate system, preferably along the inclined plane and perpendicular to it. Then, resolve all forces onto the x and y axes. In a state of equilibrium, the net forces along the x and y axes are both zero. Finally, by setting up and solving a system of equations, we can find the support force and the friction force. The third method is resolving a force by its effects. The key here is to resolve the force of gravity according to its effects. Gravity has two effects. First, it acts down the inclined plane, giving the object a tendency to slide down. Second, it acts perpendicularly into the inclined plane, pressing against it. We resolve gravity into a component gx down the incline and a component gy perpendicular to the incline. When the object is at rest, the friction force balances the component down the incline and the support force balances the component perpendicular to the incline. By direct correspondence, we can find the result. Let's analyze this again using the second method, orthogonal decomposition. Because the block has a tendency to slide down due to gravity, the inclined plane exerts an upward friction force on the block along the incline. These two forces are equal in magnitude and opposite in direction. Similarly, in the direction perpendicular to the incline, the block has the effect of pressing on the plane, so the plane exerts a support force on the block. These two forces are also equal in magnitude and opposite in direction. This kind of comparison can help us make our analysis of mechanics more concrete.